Rinkin drops back, wants to throw over the middle, wide open, Connor score! Did he come up with it? I think he did. Connor wobbled it for a moment, still had the presence of mind to keep his concentration and holds it in all the way at the Blue Valley Randolph 25-yard line. Juilliard back to throw, rush by Miller, throws, it's intercepted by Connor Storr. Storr stays on his feet, spins out of a tackle. Connor brings it back all the way to the 21 of Blue Valley Randolph. They fake it to go, they give it to Connor Storr on the end around. He's at the 10, the 5, touchdown Connor Storr.
And how fitting it is, the person who intercepts the ball for you, you get him the ball on the end around, and Connor Storr to get the 14-yard touchdown on the reverse. Extremely obvious now with the penalties, the mistakes, the lack of tackling, the holding calls, the jumping before the ball snap. You're just seeing mentally they're not there here in the second half.
They haven't played a second half since week one at Osborne. Power set, Rankin play action, wants the throw, has some time, airs it out deep, down the left hash, and diving catch by Connor Storr inside the 15, marks down to the 13, a fabulous catch by Connor Storr, who dove and used his entire body to catch the ball and hung on as he took it to the ground. What a play by Connor Store.
I vote that play of the night.
I do too. Wow.
Maybe not just here.
Wow.
He laid out, absolutely laid out, and that's as good a reception as you're going to see at any level.
Good night, and you like the response. You give up the touchdown, then you come back down. Of course, the big play was the fantastic, unbelievable catch by Connor Store.
Yes, and that seemed to spark the offense just a little bit.
Thomas and White by the back. Here's the blitz. The pitch to Thomas, running left. Miles is in for the two-point conversion, standing up, and that will end it.
What are some of the concerns that you have about going up against a team with this kind of experience and a very well-oiled machine like they are?
Well, the size, of course, that they have up front, along with their physicality, just getting off the ball and playing football, hitting you. And we've got to step up and hit back and be assertive, be aggressive, and play with confidence. A lot of that gets down to a mindset of being confident in your ability to come up and take on blocks and then being able to tackle. And if we're going to have to rise to a higher level against Clifton Clyde, we're going to have to be ready to play and ready to take on their aggressiveness and their strength and their size.
Fourth down at a yard and a half for Lakeside. Quick pitch, go White's trying to get around the edge. Has the first down and more across the 35 to the 38-yard line. A 4-yard pick up by Cole White. That quick pitch on the outside to White. Easy first down for the Lakeside Knights. That's a good job on the front line as well by the Lakeside Knights. 30-22. Lakes out of the lead. Third down and a long nine for the Knights. Rankin retreats the pass. Has some time. Throws over the top. Looking for Storr. Makes the catch at the 15 and inside the 15 to the 12. What a catch by Connor Storr. He had to turn back around, backpedaling toward the goal line with his back toward the end zone. Makes the catch inside the 15 to the 12. What a play for Lakeside. The Knights came to play tonight in Clyde on the road in district play when it mattered the most. You can't say enough about Lakeside tonight and about everybody on this football team. This was a team win at its finest tonight for the Lakeside Knights. Hill was looking to get back on track in a must situation tonight against Lakeside. And they still have a chance to make the playoffs. They need a victory tonight. Rankin retreats the pass, fires over the middle. Nice pass and a great catch by Connor Storr at the 25 and across the 25 to the 26. He talks about a rifle of a pass from Alex Rankin as he gets it across the 25 to the 27. On the play, and a first down for Lakeside, covering 22 yards. Alex Rankin in the shotgun, takes the snap, looks the pass, Rankin fires left side, over the top is caught, touchdown Connor Storr on the far sideline, perfect pass from Alex Rankin to Connor Storr, and the Knights lead 32-14 with a minute 49 to play in this third quarter. That could possibly be the dagger right now for the Lakeside Knights, the way this game is going at this point in time, the way the Knight defense is playing. .544 and counting in the game, 32-22, Lakeside leading by 10. Brockman takes the snap, takes the handoff to the fullback, falls on the turf, and it's picked up by Lakeside. Connor Storr has it at the 40, 35, 30, 25, 20, push forward, chase, not only just stepped out of bounds on the near sideline, and it did not look like Connor stepped out of bounds, but they whistle him down at the 16-yard line. A huge play nonetheless for the Lakeside Knights as they pick up the turnover. Connor Storr is a guy that we haven't probably talked about enough tonight as well. That guy's motor does not stop. He is a guy that's going to play the whole game, and he's going to play it with a complete intensity that not a lot of kids have. You know, I know a lot of people that he's worked for, too, in the work field. And they say nobody's better than Connor Storr as far as the motor that he has and everything that he does. He's a great kid, and Connor's been playing very well tonight. Hofstad backs in the backfield behind White. Play action fake. Looks over the middle. It is intercepted by Connor Storer. Picks it off for Lakeside at the Lakeside. About the 16-yard line, it looks like. Long count takes the snap. Quick flare pass to Shoemaker. Double pass down the field. Shoemaker has Storer. Makes the catch at the 35, to the 30, and down to the 28 with 19 seconds to play.